Let us start with question number 3 and question number 6 from question bank of unit number 3. So let us solve problem number 3 from question bank on unit 3. You have already seen that problem. We have already read that problem. Now we are going to solve it. Let us draw its diagram first, as given in the question. It is having force F in first quadrant at an angle theta. Then in fourth quadrant, one more force is there, which is 2.5 kilonewton. This force makes 60 degree angle. Then in third quadrant, the force is given 7.5 kilonewton. This makes 30 degree with Y. And in second quadrant, on negative Y axis, one more force is there, which is 4.5. So in this way, you can see the diagram. Four forces are there in first quadrant F at theta, then 4.5 on negative Y axis, 7.5 in third quadrant with 30 degree, and 2.5 kilonewton in fourth quadrant at 60 degree angle. These are the forces, four forces acting on the origin. This is origin, and it is asked that find the value of force F, because force F is unknown. So we have to find the value of that force F so that all four forces will be maintaining equilibrium condition. So let us start. Now we know that the equilibrium conditions that are required to solve the problem are: as this force system is a coplanar force system, so we need only, and also it is a concurrent force system because all forces are meeting at one point, that is origin. So we need only two conditions: summation fx is equal to 0, and second condition we need is summation of fy is equal to 0. So if we start with this problem, let us first use summation fx is equal to 0. Now what is summation fx is equal to 0? It is nothing but addition of all forces in horizontal direction, or it is the addition of x component of all the forces. So let us start one by one. We will start with the first force in the first quadrant, F. Now this force F can be resolved in the two directions, one is x, one is y direction. So force F will have its x component as F cos theta. This is F cos theta because it is moving towards positive x direction. So this F cos theta will be positive because force is in first quadrant. Next force is 4.5 kilonewton. As it is already on x axis, the force itself will be the x component. So minus 4.5. Now why minus? Because it is on the negative x axis. Next, third force is 7.5 kilonewton. So it will be having its x component towards negative x direction. So minus 7.5 cos 60. Now why I am using cos 60 here? Here the angle is given with y axis, which is 30 degree. But I need angle of this force with x axis, which will be 60 degree. So I am using this 60 degree angle in the calculation. So this is the third force. We have taken the x component of the third force. This is x component of second force. This is x component of the first force. Now let us move to the x component of this fourth force. Now fourth force is 2.5 kilonewton. So as it is in fourth quadrant, its x component will be moving towards the positive x direction. So plus 2.5 cos, and the angle made by the force with x axis is 60 degree. So it is equal to 0. So this will be our summation fx. Now if you solve this equation, you will be getting the value of f cos theta is equal to 7. Now let us have for equilibrium once again summation of fy, which is equal to, now it will be summation of fy, addition of all vertical forces or addition of all y component of forces. So for first force it will be f sin theta, because its y component will move up. This force will not have any y component because it is on x axis. So next, third force 7.5 minus 7.5 sin 60, as 7.5 will have y component in downward direction, so it is negative. 2.5 will also have y component in negative direction, so minus 2.5 sin 60 is equal to 0. If you solve this equation, you will get f sin theta is equal to 8.66. So by solving this equation, we got f cos theta is equal to 7. This is our first equation. F sin theta is equal to 8.66, which is our second equation. Now let us move to the next step. Now from first and second equation, from equation 1 and 2, what we can do? We can divide second equation by first equation. So it will be like f sin theta divided by f cos theta equals to 8.66 divided by 7. If you solve this, you will be getting the value of tan theta is equal to 1.23, and that is theta is equal to 51.05 degree. Now put this value in equation number 1. If you put this value in this first equation, that is f cos theta equal to 7, you will be getting value of f is equal to 11 newton, kilonewton. I have written this approximate value. By calculation, you will be getting the correct value. Now let us move to the next question, that is question number 6 from question bank. This is already displayed at the start of video. I will not read the question once again. You can refer the statement of the question from the start of the video. The diagram given in the question, I'll be drawing over here. There is one vertical wall. This is shown over here. This is vertical wall. To this vertical wall, here one pin joint is there, that is shown in the diagram, and then a boom is attached over here to that pin joint. So this is called as boom, or you can consider it as a rod also. And to support this end of the boom, one cable is there, which is also attached to the wall at this location. So this is the cable that is attached at the end point of the boom, and some dimensions are given for this cable to calculate the angles. This is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. Then this point is A, while this point is B. Here one force is acting, that is F1, and the value of this force F1 is also mentioned as 2 times F2. F1 is given as 2 times F2, that is in the problem. And one more force is given at this location, which is equal to again F2. Then the angle of the boom is given, this angle as 30 degree. Then the distances are given. This distance is given as 1.5 meter, and the remaining distance up to this point B is 1 meter. So up to this it is 1 meter. So this is the given diagram. From this given diagram, we have to draw free body diagram. So let us draw FBD of this given system. This is point A and this is point B, and here cable is attached at point C. So let us draw the FBD first. At this location A, now as there is a pin joint, first let us draw a boom. So this is our boom AB. This is point A, while this is point B. This is A. At point A, now it is shown over here that it is a pin joint. So as for the pin joint is nothing but the hinge. So there will be two reactions for that pin joint or hinge, and those two reactions will be vertical and horizontal. So this is AX, this is AY, this is A. Then the angle is also given over here. We'll use that angle to form one triangle. Now at this end point, here at point B, one force is acting, which is F1. And on the boom, here at this point, one more force is acting, which is F2. The value of F1 is also given as 2 times F2. Then the distances are given. So this is 1.5 meter distance. And then up to this point, this is 1 meter distance. So using these two distances, we can have the distances for the triangle. So this distance can be, as this angle is 30 degree and this distance is adjacent to 30 degree, this will be 1.5 cos 30, because we know that adjacent is cos while the opposite is sine. And so this total distance will become 2.5 sine 30, because AB is 2.5, so this becomes 2.5 sine 30. Similarly, then we have to show this vertical distance over here. So this distance is the opposite of 30 degree. So this will be 2.5 sine 30. This will not be sine. This will be cos. This has to be cos 30. This will not be sine 30, because adjacent side is cos while the opposite side will be sine 30. So in that case, it will be cos. One more force is remaining over here, and that is the tension in the cable BC. So here you can see this is the cable BC. So that tension in the cable need to be shown over here. So that cable is acting from B to C. So tension will be acting from this B point to C point. So that tension is TBC. That is TBC. Now what is the angle made by that tension with horizontal? That we need to find out. So I will show that angle over here. So here the dimensions are given. That is 3, 4 and 5. So using 3 and 4, we can calculate that angle. Tan inverse of 3 upon 4. So it will be tan inverse of 3 by 4, which is equal to 36.9 degree. So this angle is 36.9 degree. Now this TBC, as given in the problem, is equal to 1500 Newton. So it will have two components. One is Y component, one is X component. So Y component will be 1500 sine 36.9, while this will be the X component of this tension, and this X component will be 1500 cos 36.9. So now we have drawn this free body diagram, and now we have to apply the conditions of equilibrium. So we know that for the concurrent force system, the conditions of equilibrium are summation fx equal to 0, summation fy equal to 0. That is for coplanar concurrent system. And for non-coplanar system, Again, summation fz should be added, that we also know. But here, the system given is coplanar, but non-concurrent, because all forces do not meet at any common point. So, system is coplanar, but non-concurrent. So, here, we have to consider the conditions of equilibrium, like for equilibrium, there will be three conditions. Summation of moment about any point will be zero. Now we will be taking moment about A here. So summation of moment about A is zero. Second condition to be used is summation of Fy is equal to zero and summation of Fx is equal to zero. These three conditions of equilibrium needs to be applied over here. So let us start with first condition, that is for equilibrium, summation of moment about A is equal to zero. So that means we have to take moment about point A for all the forces shown in the diagram. So let us start with this force, that is F2. F2 will be moving towards point A, or will create clockwise moment about point A. So clockwise moment is positive. So F2 multiplied by distance of F2 from A, perpendicular distance is given here, which is 1.5 cos 30. So F2 into 1.5 cos 30. Then next force we have to consider here is this F1. F1 is also moving towards point A in the clockwise direction, or will produce turning effect in the clockwise direction. So F1 multiplied by this distance, because this is the perpendicular distance for F1. So F1 multiplied by 2.5 cos 30, but we also know that value of F1 is 2F2. So again, plus, because clockwise, 2 times F2 into 2.5 cos 30. These are the moments taken for the two forces, that is F2 and F1. Now why we are not taking the moment of AX and AY? Because as we are taking moment about point A, so AX, AY both are passing through A, so their distance from A will be zero, and so moment will be zero. Next, now we have to take moment of this TBC, which is equal to 1500 Newton. But as it is inclined, we have divided, or we have resolved this TBC into two components, that is 1500 sine 36.9, 1500 cos 36.9. So instead of taking the moment of this 1500 cos 36, instead of taking the moment of 1500 Newton directly, we will take the moment of this 1500 cos 36.9 and 1500 sine 36.9. So this vertical component will be creating anti-clockwise moment about A, so it is negative, minus 1500 sine 36.9 into the distance of this component from A, perpendicular distance is 2.5 cos 30. So 2.5 cos 30. Next, this component, that is X component of TBC, is moving towards negative X, and it will produce again anticlockwise moment. So again minus 1500 cos 36.9 multiplied by distance of this component from A. This will be the perpendicular distance, which is shown over here, which is 2.5 sine 30. So 2.5 sine 30. And we have to solve this equation, where the value of value of F2 is to be calculated, and this is equal to zero. So when we solve this equation in the calculator, we get the value of F2. So value of F2 that is calculated is 612.66 Newton. So this is the value of F2 that we have obtained. Now the same value can be used to calculate F1. As we know, F1 is equal to 2 times F2. So the value of F1 comes to 1225.32 Newton. So now we have calculated the value of F2 and F1. Now also it is said in the problem that calculate the support reactions. So that is AX and AY is to be calculated here. So use the second condition of equilibrium. Now we have used this condition, and let us use the second condition. Summation of Fy is equal to 0. Use this condition. So add all forces in y direction. So first is ay, first force, then f2, so minus 612.66, then f1 minus 1225.32, upward positive, downward negative. So this one, then this force, but it is having y component upward, so this component is to be added. So plus 1500 sine 36.9 is equal to 0. If you solve this equation, then you get ay. So value of ay is equal to 937.35 newton. Similarly, now we have to find ax, that is x component of reaction at point A. So use third condition of equilibrium, summation fx equal to 0, here it is mentioned, that is to be used. So add all forces in x direction. So first force is ax in x direction, second force is x component of 1500, so minus 1500 cos 36.9, and so ax comes to 1199.53 newton. So now we have calculated all the answers. Required answers are f2, f1, ay and ax. So you can write down here the required answers. So in this way we have solved two problems. In the first one, it was based on the concurrent force system where we have to use only two conditions of equilibrium. The second problem was on the non-concurrent force system where we have to use again two conditions of equilibrium, that is summation fx0, summation fy0, and the third one is also required, that is summation of moment equal to 0. Now we will move to the next problem. Next problem will be based on Lami's theorem. How to solve the problems using Lami's theorem? So our next question is question number 12 from the question bank.
This is question number 12 from question bank.
So this is the given range that I am drawing over here, where the cylinder is resting in this range, having weight 1000 Newton. So the cylinder is drawn over here. You can see that there are two contact points. First is here, that is contact point A. Second contact point is here, that is contact point B, and the weight is 1000 Newton. Then the angle is also given over here, that this angle is 30 degree. So let us draw its free body diagram first now, FBD. So let us draw this cylinder as it is. As we know that weight of the cylinder is 1000 Newton, it will be acting in the downward direction, 1000 Newton. Now this is the contact point B, while this is the contact point A. Now as this range is having one wall vertical, so reaction at this point A will be horizontal and it will be exactly passing through center of the circle. So at this point A, we will have one reaction in this direction. So that reaction is called as RA, and it will be passing through this center of the circle. And at B also, we will have one more reaction perpendicular to the surface, perpendicular to this surface of the range. So this is reaction RB. It is also passing through center of circle in this way. Then angle of this reaction RB will be shown over here. So here you can see this angle is 30 degree. So this angle will be 60 degree, because here the reaction is perpendicular to the surface. So this is how the free body diagram is drawn over here. Now using the principle of transmissibility, let us draw those forces once again. This is the C center of circle. This is C center of circle. At point C, Now instead of having reaction A moving towards C, I am showing it moving away from C. So this is the reaction RA. Then one more force in this direction. As RB is moving towards B, as per the law of transmissibility, it will be moving away from C here. So this is RB, and at C this force is there, weight 1000 newton. So we have drawn this. Now let us have the angles. As here you can see, this angle of RB is 60, so here also this angle will be 60. As RA is horizontal, weight is vertical, so this is 90 degree. As this is 60, this angle has to be 120 degree. Then this is 90 degree. As this is 60 and this is 90, so 90 plus 60 will be this angle, so this angle will be 150 degree. So we have all the three angles: 150 degree, 120 degree, 90 degree. Now as per Lami's theorem, it states that each force is proportional to sine of angle between remaining two forces. So by Lami's theorem, by using Lami's theorem, we can write RA divided by, this is RA divided by angle, sine of angle between remaining two. So remaining two are 1000 and RB. So sine 150 degree, which is equal to RB divided by sine, angle between remaining two is 90. So sine 90, which is equal to 1000 divided by this angle, sine angle between remaining two. So 1000 force ko aap consider karte ho, to angle between remaining two is 120 degree. So now we have this equation with us. Now we can equate first ratio and the third ratio, then we can equate second ratio and the third ratio, and then we can calculate the value of RA and RB. So RA will be equal to 1000 upon sine 120 multiplied by sine 150, and that is equal to 577.35 newton. Similarly, we can solve the equation for RB also. RB is equal to 1000 upon sine 120 multiplied by sine 90. So after solving this equation, we will get the value of RB. This is the value of RA. Well, now here we will get the value of RB, and it will be 1154.7 newton. So in this way we can solve the problem on Lami's theorem. Let us move to the our next question. Is question number 10 from the question bank. It will be again based on the Lami's theorem. So the question is, the 30 kg pipe is supported at A by a system of 5 cords as shown in figure. Determine the force in each cord for equilibrium. So we have to solve this question for equilibrium. So let us start with this. Here you can see that the diagram for question number is 10. Question number 10 is drawn over here. So in which there are 5 cables, cable AB, BC, then cable BD, these are the 3 cables, cable AE, and one more cable is acting in the downward direction where 30 kg load is supported. And we have to find the tension in each cable. We have to find the tension in each cable, and only the angle at this location at 60 degrees is given. And here you can find the angle as it is 3 and 4. This angle, we can calculate this angle, which can be 36.9, as we have already calculated that in the first above problem also, earlier problem also, not in the first one. So let us break this system of cables at this location. Let us break it. Now when we break this system of cable at this location, now on the lower part there are 3 cables, cable A, cable AB, and cable which is connected to 30 kg load. Let us draw the free body diagram of this portion of the cable system over here. So this is point A, then this is cable AE, so this will be tension AE, tension in the cable TAE. Then one more cable is acting in this direction, so this is TAB. The angle is given over here, this is 60 degree, and in this direction this is 30 kg into 9.81, this is the load. So this is 60 degree, that means this total angle becomes 150 degree. If this is 60, this is again 120, and this is again 90 degree. Let us apply Lami's theorem for this particular diagram. So it will be like TAE, tension in cable AE, divided by sine 150, which is equal to TAB divided by sine 90, which is equal to this 30 into 9.81 into 9.81 divided by remaining two, angle between remaining two, it is 120, sine 120. So we have applied Lami's theorem over here, and now by using Lami's theorem we can calculate the values of TAE and TAB. So solving this equation, we get the value of TAE. So TAE comes to 169.9 Newton, and TAB it comes to 339.83 Newton. So we have got the values for this system of force, that is for the lower part of the cable system. Now let us consider the upper part of the cable system for equilibrium. This is we have considered for equilibrium. Now free body diagram for this upper portion of the cable system is drawn over here. So you can see this is tension TBD in the cable BD, this is tension TBC acting in the cable BC, and this is tension AB acting in this part of cable AB. Now as this angle is 60 degree, then this opposite angle will be also 60 degree. So definitely this angle will be 120. Now as this is 60 degree and this is 36.9, so this total angle becomes 96.9. How this is 36.9? It is tan inverse of 3/4. From tan inverse of 3/4 you can calculate this is 36.9. So this remaining angle becomes 143. So remaining angle becomes 143.1. So this is the free body diagram again. Again here there are three concurrent forces, so we can use Lami's theorem. So I'm writing the equation for Lami's theorem over here. It will be 339.83 divided by, this is 339 divided by sine of 143.1, that is equal to TBD divided by sine 120, that is equal to TBC divided by sine 96.9. if you solve this equation, we get the answers TBD is equal to 490.16 Newton, and second answer TBC is equal to 561.89 Newton. So in this way, by applying Lami's theorem, we have got the answers. Thank you.